And guess what? They got it. How about that?
And now a two-point conversion away from tying this game up. And it's caught. And with it, we are tied here in the fourth. Huge, huge conversion there to tie this thing up, but they're not done yet. Their defense needs to get a stop.
Yeah, there's still plenty of time for the other team to come downfield and put some points on the board, but job one was taken care of, the two-point conversion to get this thing tied.
Hill going to sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called.
And now off to the races, down the right side. And they're going to have this way down in Cincinnati territory. A big play there on the catch and run. Charles, just a gigantic play right there.
Absolute breakdown defensively, but take no credit away. A huge gain, and that turns things around.
A game-winning field goal would be a chip shot from here. Let's see how they play it on first and goal. Try to pound it in, Kamara. And he'll be stopped just outside the five at the six. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
Back to the ground. This time it's Peterson. And he will push his way forward down to about the three-yard line. They follow up the first down one-yard run with a minimal gain of two. They'll run for it with Peterson. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. And they're going to get the timeout call. What a finish. We're down to 4 seconds to go in this football game. And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
Charles and I settled here in the booth. This should be a fun one. Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a look at some of the stars here of today's game. Let's get right to it. Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Indianapolis. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Pass to Henry is intercepted. Picked off by Greg Newsom. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six for a Bengals TD.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. And he's got it to make it 7-0 Bengals.
Makes the score Bengals 7, Colts nothing. Harrison Butker set to kick off.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
Let's take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go. First carry for Raheem Mostert. And he'll get about 6 up to the 27-yard line.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
From the gun, a run with Mostert. And give him about 4 on the play, but he's marked short, so it'll be 3rd and about the length of the football. They'll try and run here with Mostert. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, 3 plays, all 3 short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
To throw, Huntley. Flushed out right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but if they make them out of bounds, that does you no good.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Huntley to throw. They're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
So many times we've seen him try to escape the pocket and do something with his legs, but in this case, the pressure was too intense, and he made the wise choice to just get rid of the football and make sure no one was going to get it.
Here's Huntley. He'll let this thing go for Sanders. It got his man complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards. And he'll get 3 down to the 34-yard line.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out. And they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Looking to throw on 2nd down. Huntley. Open man here, the tight end Henry. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. A big connection on that one. 33 yards. Well, make that now 2 completions for him on this drive, and these aren't ordinary completions. interceptions, they're big ones.
Yeah, and these are the types that make a secondary talk to each other and not in a good way, oftentimes pointing fingers. Hey, who's got it? Someone cover it. That type of indecision can open up to even more big plays.
And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage.
Brings up second and goal at the 2-yard line.
To throw on second down, Huntley. And that one going to come up short, low throw.
And he's only hit on two of his first six passes. Time for a quick quarterback regroup here with a big third down coming up.
This Bengal defense, they passed the first two tests. Now it's third and goal. Here's a run with Mixon. And Mixon not going to get there. Running into a wall here, and they'll stop him short. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one. Rodrigo Blankenship for the Colts field goal. This a chip shot, a 20-yarder. Blankenship's kick is good. So a long drive gets him down inside the five, but ultimately they settle for just the field goal.
And I have to think that if maybe they were a yard closer, that would have made their decision tougher, and I think they likely would have gone for it. But in this situation, they just decided to take the three, and I think it was a smart move.
Taken in at the three. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
At their own 17-yard line.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Here's Vic. He finds his man complete. That's Peterson. 7 yards there on the first down screen play. So Charles, first drive here, a little safe completion underneath. Maybe get some rhythm, get your feet wet, so to speak.
I agree, and I like it because it's a lot like a basketball game when you're getting started and you pass the ball around so everyone touches it early and gets involved in the game. In this case, it's not just dumping it to a back and he's able to run with the ball, but you get your offensive linemen involved because they get to get out and run and hit people in the open field. Everyone getting their feet wet early.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. From the shotgun, it's Vic dancing to his left. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. Odell Beckham Jr. with a diving grab. A big play that time through the air. 36 yards. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. A first down throw coming for Vic. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. He's got it. Touchdown, Bengals. Odell Beckham, 40 yards. And the Bengals are able to grow their lead.
That appeared like any routine NFL quarterback, but it was Michael Vick from the pocket, throws a touchdown pass. And I just think about the transformation throughout his career. From Atlanta, where he would take off and go at just about the drop of a hat and turn defenses into mush. And then by the end of his career in Philadelphia, where he completed pass like we just saw from the pocket, yet still had those great legs, when necessary, to help get him out of trouble.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and that pushes the lead up to 11. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he returns this to the 22.
On the return, the Colts take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder, puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. A first down run there by Mostert as he'll get this forward for a gain of about three. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven.
Brings up second and seven at the 41-yard line.
Back to throw. Huntley getting this out to the flat. Mostert.
I know it was a game, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay game.
First and 10 at the 30-yard.
On first and 10, it's Mostert. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
We've got a 14-3 ball game with 2 minutes left in the opening half. Remind you in just a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Orlando and our good friend Jonathan Coachman. Coach will run through some of the numbers and the next gen stats from this first half of football so far. He's going to drop this underneath to Mostert, and he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals' 12-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
We are beginning to turn you up. Don't get nervous. Hey, check 25.
They run out of the shotgun with Mostert, and he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Well, that call makes sense, because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Looking to throw on second down. Huntley forced out to his left. And inside the 5 here before he's out of bounds right at the 3. He turned that into a nice game. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down. They'll try and sneak it here. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1.
There may have been a little bit of an element of surprise there. Third and inches, and they go quarterback sneak. I still feel like this is a play that often is reserved for fourth down.
It's a quarterback sneak, and he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown. A great effort there, keeping it himself from a yard out. And the Colts get a late score here in the final minute of the first half. They'll try and throw for it. And the Colts are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. And the formula there on the two-point try to go 5 wide, not even the option to hand the ball off. They got it.
They tried to create space, and there isn't a whole lot of it there. For the defense, what you're trying to do is make sure that if someone, if they're going to catch the ball, make them catch it behind you, because they run out of space with the back line. But in this case, the offense figured it out.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And we'll see how they want to play this. Just a little over 20 seconds to go. Vick will look to throw on first down. Out to his left. It's caught by OBJ. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Vick operating on first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it And that'll fall incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Throwing again on second and 10. Vic, that's caught. It's Ahmad Rashad. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts 43. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. This will be the final play of the half. Vic. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So we have reached halftime here, and it's the visiting Bengals out in front. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three.
Set to receive. They have the lead and the football to begin quarter number three. This will be fielded inside the five.
Odell Beckham on the return. The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Bengals drive about to get going. Hey, Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
The throw on second down from Vic, incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
On third down, Vic. They're looking for Judy, but it's intercepted. Steeler legend Troy Polamalu with a pick. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind. And we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
3 yards the gain there, second down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
To throw on second down, Huntley going right back to Fant. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover. And they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
They'll try to run it in, going option right. And he's brought down right at the 5-yard line. Give him 2 on the play.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you expect it to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. The sack by T.J. Watt, or as his mother, Connie, calls him, Trent Jordan Watt.
That's quite a stand there defensively. A huge sack on third down, and that's going to force him into a field goal attempt.
And that is no good. And this score will stay down here in the third quarter. Obviously, that's one they could have used.
Yeah, and one of my favorite special teams coaches in the NFL told me what separates the kickers in the NFL versus the ones who are not is not the misses. It's the second miss in a row. Best kickers in the league, they don't miss two in a row. He's got to get his head back together in case he gets another shot.
Breaks the tackle. He's got room to run. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
And a good physical run that time. He's going to wind up gaining 5 on that one. It's a play fake. Now Vic rolling to his right. Over the middle to Beckham. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 39-yard line. From the pistol, they run with Peterson. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. They'll keep it on the ground. Peterson, he winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we play three quarters. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. The battle in the trenches, never more important than right now. This is third and inches. Try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he is going to have a Bengals first down, maybe by about a yard as they find a way to convert on third and inches. On play action, Vic. It's caught, Beckham. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. They give it to Peterson. He's down inside the 10 to the 8, and it comes on a gain of 8. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. He'll buy some time right, and that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. Odell Beckham, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bengals, they widen their lead.
But that makes this a 2-score ball game. And, you know, the way this thing has been going, Charles, 2 scores kind of feels like 3 or 4 scores.
Yeah, that's a great observation. It's been a heck of a battle, hasn't it? And points have been at a premium throughout this game. So you have to wonder, is this going to be too much for them to overcome?
Extra point by Butker is on target.
And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Colts take over the first down at their own 25-yard line.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go.
And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by 2 scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical.
Buying time to his left. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. From the gun, Huntley. Complete, Hunter Henry with a grab. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Brings up third and 6.
Looking to throw. Huntley. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Darius Slay with a pick.
Charles and I set for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup as we get a peek some of the stars in today's game. Well, will they be stars? Will you be a star? We'll find out. Let's play. Nick Folk ready to put this one in the air. And off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. And now we get a peek at some of the top players here for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis ready to go in the booth. We hope you're ready to go at the controls. Let's play. Nick Folk ready to put this one in the air. And here we go. We're underway in Madden Ultimate Team. And this is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. First
first down, Vic. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
But they certainly came out firing in this one, and while that one was incomplete, I can't imagine that'll be the last shot that they take in this game.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. A first carry now for Adrian Peterson. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Third play here, this opening drive as they're up against a 3rd and 5. Now here's Vic. Here's a screen to Powell. And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33. Running for it, here's Peterson. And I don't think he got there. He did not. They stop him a yard shy. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Romo. Throw left side complete. That's Sanders. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7.
Let's face it, that what we just saw there, not a surprise, is it? I mean, this is what he does well. And if you don't tackle him as soon as he catches the ball, this is the end result. Big yardage afterwards.
Got the speed, the agility, so good with run after catch. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Derrick Henry taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Cowboys on just 2 plays have taken the lead. Fulk connects on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Fulk now set to boot it after his guys put 6 on the board. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Bengals drive about to get going. And last time out, went for it on 4th down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on 4th down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on 1st down. Now it's AP, Adrian Peterson. And he can only manage to get a couple. 2nd and 8 coming up. The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. Off the play fake, Vic. Trying to get it to Beckham, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Reggie Nelson. And they will finally stop it, but a great return. Gets that football all the way down to the 16-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the
And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. He couldn't get rid of it. He winds up losing a yard. It's 2nd down. Now it's Romo. Escaping the pressure right. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the 1st down.
Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. sack leads to roughly a loss of six, and it brings up second and goal. Out of the gun, Romo. Under pressure, and they got to him again. T.J. Watt causing the disruption. He gets the sack. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Two straight sacks have them backed up now for a third and goal. From the gun, here's Romo. And right side, Henry's got it. Touchdown, Cowboys! Derrick Henry! He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Cowboys will extend their lead. Extra point up and good by Folk. And it's now 14-0. Folk now set to boot it after his guys put six on the board. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Bengals drive about to get going. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So, they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
Steps away to his left. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way down to the 26. A big play there for Cincinnati.
And that might be exactly what they needed to wake up this home crowd. They haven't given them much to cheer for so far. And never underestimate the effect the home crowd with you can have on a game.
First down, here's a run with Peterson. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
Second and six.
Play action now, Vic. He'll have a first down inside the 10. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. Odell Beckham, a 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Bengals have got it back to a one-score game. Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. And that one makes it 14-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
It was Marcel Harris out of Florida making the tackle that time. Here's Romo. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. T.J. Watt, his second sack of the night. So that now four first-half sacks. This pass rush has been unrelenting.
Partner, you hear that sound of paper being ripped to shreds? That's a game plan that they've had so far because they've got to say to themselves right now, we have to do something differently.
A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coach's two-minute drill.
And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. Here's A.J. Cole now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And the Bengals will take over in terrific field position. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Vic goes play action. Flush to his right. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. He was out there waving his arms. I mean, you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help. I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. Vic now on the move to his left. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Michael Vick, a 10-yard touchdown run. And the Bengals are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Extra point by Butker is on target, and we are tied here in the second quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Tie ball game, still a little more than a minute to go in the half. The question, can they put something together here, try to take that lead into intermission?
I would have to think that would be the goal for sure. I don't think you sit on anything here. Here's your opportunity, push it downfield. As you mentioned, it's a tie game. So minus a disaster on your part, you've got that in your back pocket. Go ahead and try and get some points and feel great going into the half.
He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. Well, look, we're watching a quarterback here that's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before. Didn't happen to get it completed in this case.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. On first and 10, here's Vic. On the throw, led him too much that time. It's incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
To throw on second and 10, Vic. And that is incomplete.
Well, they've had success getting the ball to him out of the backfield, but this time they had a man right on him. He was able to break that play up before he could get started.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Here's Michael Vick. They're looking for Judy, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Jason Verrett.
Pick, baby. You see it?
You can easily see the logic. It's a tie game. They just wanted to press it a little bit right before the half, hoping to get one more score.
Yeah, easy to second guess the result, but now you have to think after that interception, just a field goal, and they're behind at the break.
Yeah, I think at the half, the head coach just says, look, that's on me. I wanted to press it, but it's because I believe in you guys.
Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Now Romo. pressure right. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. Romo. Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Well, they were in a great position to take the lead, Charles. Obviously, all they needed was a field goal to do that. They wanted the touchdown. Unfortunately, they're going to get neither.
And you know every offense talks about the same thing each week, don't they, Brandon? They want to end every drive with a kick, whether it's a field goal attempt, a point after the touchdown, or worst, a punt. This time they had that opportunity but didn't get it, because you know the field shrinks that close to the end zone, and that allows the defense to tighten up their coverage, and they picked that one off.
And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here and ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic, no need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. Again, it's Henry. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll fake the give. Now Romo. Sliding out of the pocket. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
On second down, Samuel. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. A 1 yard gain there following the 3 yard pickup on first down. Throwing on third down, Romo. Open man, the longtime Cowboy, Billy Joe Dupree. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. The QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
A gain of 3, second down.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. Here's Romo. This will go to Henry out wide. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line.
But they're getting ready to go to work now in prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot. Picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. Romo's throw caught by Sanders. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. On second down, here's Henry. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5 yard line. Gonna do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. The try and run for it on first and goal. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Romo now to throw it. And this is going to be intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off. He's at the 50, 30, 10.
Bring in the second string. Bring in the second string.
It's a pick six for Bengals TV. In a tie game, fourth quarter, that's about as big of a defensive play as you can possibly make.
And it didn't happen by accident. That was scouting right there. They've seen things that have happened before. They knew in certain situations type of plays they like to run. Read it, and were able to go after the football, get it, and take it into the end zone for a touchdown for themselves.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and the lead is now 21-14. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And can they regroup? That's the question. The pick six hurt, no doubt, but this is still a one-score game here in the fourth. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. Now Romo. Oh, going for Sanders downfield. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Greg Newsom. And the Bengals are going to take over here up near the 40.
I'm not sure